In this video, we are going to demonstrate how to use the free HWg-cloud and the paid SensDesk portal and how to move devices in between them. Currently, HWg Group provides two different portal services to manage devices centrally over the cloud. One is HWg-cloud, which is a free service, and SensDesk as a paid service. The free service has a limit of 20 devices per account. The paid service device support varies by package. The free service only offers email alerts with limited features. The paid service includes SMS and voice alerts as well. Data history is 10 days in the free service and up to 1 year in the paid service. PDF reports, multigraphs, open APIs are only available in the paid service. HWg-cloud is the default service for all new devices. Devices are registered to the free service via the adoption process, and from there, it can be migrated to a paid service. It is also possible to move the device from paid service back to the HWg-cloud free service. In this video, we are going to demonstrate how to adopt an SD device into the free service using the adoption and later migrate to the SensDesk paid subscription. Please note that SensDesk is not a single portal. Local distributors and partners operate SensDesk portals as well. To demonstrate the device adoption, I'm going to use this SD2X in that you can see here. And if I change the view, you can see that that's the local management side. So if I just operate this simple switch, which is connected to the input, you can see that the input changes. So now it is open, and when I let it goes to close. I've already completed the initial setup of this device. So this is connected to the internet using the Wi-Fi that I configured here. So now this device is ready to be added to the HWg-cloud website. I've created myself an account, I've logged in as you can see here, and all I need to do is click on Adopt Device here. When you want to adapt an SD or a narrowband device, you will see on the side that it has a hash code that you can see here. But in this case, I can also see the hash code up here. So this is this 5905-1DB9, and I just need to click on Adopt. And when I go into the devices page, I can see the SD2 already showing here. And if I go to the details page, you can see that the input one is closed and the input two is open. And I can also see the changes here. So I can make a change by pushing the button. And then after some time, this update is going to show up in the page as well. So now I push a switch on the input one. And as you can see, input one and input two is open at the moment, and I also push this switch a couple of times. So if I zoom into the recent history, now I can see the different switching appearing in the history as well. Now this SD device is assigned to my HWg-cloud account, which can hold up to 20 devices. So if I'm running out of device spaces, or if I need the additional functionality that SensDesk provide, I can migrate device over to a paid service. So I come to the device information page, and here I can find a link which says migrate to paid service. So I click here, and I need to provide the team password and the login, and I need to select the portal that I want to migrate to. So let's say I want to migrate it to the SensDesk portal. And within the SensDesk portal, first I'm going to check what is my team ID and the team password. And I'm just going to copy the team password and I'm going to use it here. And I'm going to save. And now if I go over to my SensDesk account and I click on devices, now I can see that my new SD device is available here. So if I click, I can see the same options here. What you will notice is that when you migrate over to SensDesk, or as a matter of fact, when you migrate between any of the portals, you are going to lose the history. So if you remember over to the HWg-cloud, we had a history of some changes here on the inputs, but now on the SensDesk, we don't have anything. And of course, any new changes to the input are now going to be locked here. We just have to wait for that update to come through in a couple of seconds. Once I've migrated my device to SensDesk or any other paid service, it doesn't mean that device should stay in that paid service forever. It is possible to migrate it back to the free HWg-cloud service. So as you can see, I also have a migrate to paid service link here, where the word paid here means that it can be migrated to other paid services, as we have seen from the dropdown. but it is also possible to move it back to the HWg-cloud. So you always have the option to have a free account and a paid account and move the devices in between them depending on how much devices you have and what sort of functionality you need for each of your devices.